everybody, welcome back to my channel. My name is Jaslyn and welcome back to a weekly vlog. Today I'm going to be doing a how much I read in a week while working a 9-to-5 because I just feel like it. I'm back reading again. I took a little bit of a break because I like finished a really good book and then I hit a reading slump for like 2-3 weeks. So now I'm back. Today is Monday, August 21st. I'm reading two books right now. So I'm firstly reading The Only One Left by Riley Sager. This is actually a book club pick for my in-person book club. And that is on Thursday and I'm still not done with this book. I am at like 75% through the book. So I really want to finish it today. So I'm going to be reading this during like my lunch break and stuff. This book is about a caretaker named... This is about a caretaker named Kit who is given a job to take care of a old woman who is suspected to have murdered her whole family like years ago when she was like 16, named Lenora Hope. And it's just the whole investigation of her, of Kit trying to find out who actually did it and all the craziness that happened the actual day of the murders. And it's really good so far. I've heard a lot of good things about it. Now, would I say this is my favorite Riley Sager book? I don't know. I've only read one other Riley Sager book, which I can't remember what it was called. It was the one where the main character was like at an apartment and stuff. I can't remember. I'll put it here, but I really enjoyed that one. So we'll see once I get to the end how I feel, but that's what I'm currently physically reading. And then I'm listening to Someone's Listening by Serafina Nova Glass. I finished one. This is the book I'm listening to. I'm read another one of her books, like I listened to it and it was really good. So this one is really good too. I'm only 16% in and there was a big like twist already because I was not expecting what happened to happen. So this book is about our main character, don't remember her name, but her husband goes missing and she's trying to figure out what happened, and she's a psychologist. And something happens where she starts receiving notes from someone anonymously from the book that she wrote. And it's just her trying to figure out what happened to her husband, because right now they're saying that he left on his own accord. Like he just wanted to get away from everything. But she's like, I don't think that's the truth. And she's trying to figure out what happened. It's really good so far. Only thing I don't love is the narrator, because it's kind of, her voice is kind of weird. But I'm pushing through. I'm really enjoying the book right now. And I'm about to head into work because I just pulled in the parking lot. Okay, everyone, I just got back from work. Sorry if you can hear Duke drinking water. I'm 87% through The Only One Left. I am gonna finish it tonight just so I can be done with it and start a new book, but I'm really enjoying it. The plot twist hit like right after I updated you guys this morning of where I was at. I think I was at like 75%, because like the first 75% it was good, but it was also like, it was like eh, like okay, we get it, like this stuff is happening. And then it hit the twist and I was like, oh, I was not expecting that. And now we're just learning more stuff in the book, so it's really good so far. I'm predicting if this isn't going to be 5-star for me, because even when the twist came I was like, okay, that's cool. It wasn't like, oh my gosh, wow, like that's crazy. I don't know, I just think this kind of story just didn't hit for me for some reason. Don't get me wrong, it is a really good book, I really enjoy it, but it wasn't my favorite thriller I've ever read. And I think I've been reading too much thriller, so that might also have a reason why I'm like not as shocked, because I've been reading thriller back to back to back. So I'm definitely gonna break it up after this. I do have a mini like book haul that I'm gonna show you guys like right after I eat dinner, because I'm making pizza rolls right now. But I did go to Books A Million this past weekend and I do want to do a little haul. But yeah, it's pretty good so far. I only have like 3 annotations, but once the twist started happening, that's when I actually started annotating. But that was like 80% into the book. But yeah, so that's my update. I'm gonna go ahead and eat dinner and I will check in with you guys later. I'm gonna go upstairs and like listen to the rest of it after I'm done eating. So I'm gonna come and show you guys the books I got from Barnes and Noble, Books A Million. Don't mind Brooklyn, she's just there. I only got 3 books, but it was just a weekend where I really wanted to go book shopping. I didn't have anything to do, so I went. The first book I got was The Paper Girls of Paris. This sounded really, really fun. It is a mystery slash romance where, yeah, so a 16-year-old girl inherits her apartment in Paris that has been locked for over 70 years, and she's just finding out family secrets along the way. Yeah, and it says, and then I think it's a dual timeline between now when she inherits the apartment to the past where one of her other family members has the apartment, and it just shows the juxtaposition of those. And then it says, although separated by generations, Alice and Adeline's fates are intertwined in both heartbreaking and hopeful. So it looked really good, and I really liked it because it's based in Paris, and I took French for 3 years in high school and then 2 years in college. So that's really one of the reasons I got that book. And it was on sale. It was $5.97 at Books a Million. Then I got Threads That Bind by Hatezupolo. I hope that's how you pronounce her name, but I really, really enjoyed this cover. This is a YA fantasy, I believe. It says, Threads That Bind is a thrilling magical twist on the murder mystery. So that sounds really, really good. And they had an audio version of this in my library, so I put that on hold. So hopefully I can start that sometime soon. And then this one is like the first book I saw, and I was really, really excited to get it. This is Under the Influence by Noelle Crooks. Now this sounded really, really good because it combined like my two like most interesting things that I like, which are thrillers and like influencers. So this is a book about a woman who is just over her job in the city, and she finds a influencer that is looking for basically like a personal assistant, and she's like a self-help influencer. But it starts to go downhill when she starts to figure out like what is really going on in this woman, in this influencer's like business. And it's really like self-help. So I really enjoy watching like anti-MLM and like anti-pyramid scheme videos, and this is really reminding me of this because it says like, the little blurb up here says, the Devil Wears Prada meets the assistants in this compulsively readable debut following a young woman who takes a job working for an influencer and quickly discovers there is an ugly side to being a hashtag girl boss. I felt like this is just gonna be really, really fun. This might be my next read, but I'm also trying to get out of like my thriller thing because I don't want to get into a reading slump, so I might change to one of these or something else on my, you know, bookshelf. I don't know. But I just wanted to show you guys those real quick while I go and finish the only one left, and I will chat with you guys later. Guys, happy Tuesday. I am actually working from home today. I just started my lunch break. Brooklyn is right here acting crazy because they're pressure washing the front and the back of the house, and Brooklyn can hear them, so she's barking at them, which is, that is fun. So we're just all up here. Duke is over here too, but Duke, he does not care at all. He does not care that there's people out here. But Brooklyn, she is kind of anxious. She's an anxious girly. She doesn't like random people at the house. So we're just chilling in here. I think I'm going to try to read some, but I don't think I'm going to be able to focus if Brooklyn is barking. But I did finish The Only Ones Left last night, and I gave it 4.5 stars. The twists were twisting. Right when I ended that clip of me explaining, like, dang, I don't know if I like this that much. It might just be a 4-star, blah, blah, blah. The twists were twisting. Like, they were coming boom, 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 boom. It was great. I loved the book, so I gave it 4.5 stars. I started The Dead Romantics by Ashley Poston. And I think she went to USC. I think I saw an article about her sometime last year. And I recognized this cover, and I was like, I have that book. And I saw another booktuber I watched. She has a new release that I want to read, but I'm trying to get down on my physical TBR, so I was like, let me go ahead and read this. I'm only 18 pages into it, but I'm really enjoying it so far. It's about she's a ghostwriter, and she falls in love with a ghost, so that seems really fun. Like I said, I'm only like 5% into it, so if I can't read any during my lunch because Miss Ma'am won't stop barking, then I will probably read it after work, and we will see what happens. Just wanted to give you guys a quick... Hey guys, today is Wednesday. I came on here to update you guys. I just got home from work about not even 30 minutes ago. Brooklyn and Duke are just, can you see them? They're just doing their thing over here. You know, just normal dog things. But I wanted to come on and give you a reading update. So last time I talked to you, started The Dead Romantics. And I'm not really that far into it. What does my story graph say? I am only 10% into it because I'm really in like an audiobook mood. Oh, also I DNF'd Someone's Listening because I just couldn't get past the narrator's voice. And the female character in there was just being really annoying low-key. Like, it was a thriller, but like she was doing all the wrong things. And like after a while I was like, girl, get yourself together. Like, I don't know what to tell you. You're just not doing what you're supposed to do and you're getting on my nerves. So I DNF'd that. I don't know if I'll go back to it. Maybe if I read it like physically, then I might, but I just couldn't get through the narrating. Then I started a dark romance, which was crazy because I have not read a dark romance in a while. And that is Empire of Lust by J.L. Beck. When they say a dark romance, they meant dark romance. This is a best friend's dad, age gap, obviously, romance. And I'm only 10% in and they are just, yeah, they're, yeah. So this is our main character. I can't remember their names, but the female character, I really can't remember her name, but I'm really enjoying it. Not even for like the spice and romance aspect because I'm only 10% in, but this girl, she just graduated college and she's trying to figure out what she wants to do with her life. And I felt like that was very relatable because I just graduated college and I'm still in that like kind of area of like what I want to do with my life. Did I make the right decisions? Am I not doing enough? Am I doing too much? What do I want my life to be? Like that existential crisis you usually have after graduation, that's where I currently am. Even though I have a full-time job and it may seem like I have it all together, I really don't. And that's really what our main character in this book is going through. So I just really related to that aspect of the female character. So I'm really, really enjoying that. I started reading that last night before I went to bed and it was really good. And then I started listening to, what is it called? I started listening to And There He Kept Her by Joshua Moeling. I think that's how you pronounce his name. And I'm really, really enjoying this book. I randomly found this on Hoopla because I was looking for recommendations after I stopped listening to Someone's Listening because I just couldn't do it. And I found this and I read the synopsis and I was like, that sounds really good. And I really, really, this is about a teenage couple who goes into this really old and creepy guy's house who happens to be a murderer. And they went there to steal drugs and one of them ends up getting, you know, well, that's a spoiler, so let me not say that. But some stuff happens and a detective, what's his name? I forget the detective's name, but he is solving the case. So it's a, you know, basic mystery thriller. But what I'm really enjoying about this, first of all, the detective is gay, which is really refreshing because I think a lot of like regular detective mysteries are just an old man solving crimes and that's it. And you learn a lot of backstory about this detective because I'm pretty sure this is a series. I know this author just came out with his second book in this universe like a couple weeks ago, but I just found him now, which I'm really, really enjoying the book with that aspect of the LGBTQ representation. And also we're learning a lot more about the characters, not just he solves crimes and that's it. Like you learn a lot about his backstory, why he moved to this specific area in the first place, like how he, why he's a detective here in the first place, which is really interesting. And it's honestly really reminding me of like a good Criminal Minds episode, because Criminal Minds, that's like my favorite show, and this book is really giving me those vibes because you learn a lot about the actual case obviously, but you also learn backstory about the people solving the crimes. So this detective in particular, you learn a lot about his backstory, why he does what he does, who he is, and it's not just like a regular crime show. It's like you're learning about all the characters and not just the actual plot, because I don't know. And it's just really good because Criminal Minds is my all-time favorite show and I have not watched it in a long time because that's really a comfort show. And I watched that in a kind of sad time in my life during high school. I was just going through a lot of stuff and now I really can't watch it as my comfort show as much as I want to, because whenever I watch it I associate it with that time in my life. I still watch it sometimes, but not as much as I want to because I watched it at that specific moment in my life. So this book is just giving me those vibes and just how I felt when I watched Criminal Minds for the first time. And I'm just really enjoying it and I'm really liking the book. And I'm already like 50% through the book and I started it today. So if that doesn't tell you anything, because I'm a YouTube girly through and through, podcast, and I've been listening to this book all day. So it's pretty good. But today is Wednesday, so I have date night with Michael. He should be here in like an hour. I'm waiting for him to get off work. Fed Brooklyn and Duke. I went to the gym this morning, which is my first time going to the gym all this week. So, because I did not go yesterday because I honestly didn't feel like I could have gone. And then Monday, I barely slept, so I didn't go. So this is my first day back. And I'm trying to see, because my sleep schedule has been jacked up this week. Like, I'll go to bed at 10:30, wake up at 2 o'clock in the morning, can't go back to sleep. That's the original reason I didn't go to the gym on Monday, because I just couldn't sleep. So I'm trying to figure out, is it because I drank too much coffee, or it's because I didn't go to the gym, because going to the gym does help me sleep better, or is it something else? So I'm trying to figure that out. So we'll see how I sleep tonight and I'll let you know tomorrow. But that is that. Michael and I are going to get Chinese food for dinner, which I'm very excited about. And then I think we're gonna watch a K-drama that we started like months ago and never finished. I don't remember what it's called, but I'll put a little picture here because I'm in my K-drama era. That is it for now. This is a very long update, but I'm just very excited about what I'm reading right now. And yeah. Thursday. Right now it is 5:19. I just finished listening to And There He Kept Her. I gave it a 4.5 stars. I really, really enjoyed this book. I'm very glad that I really just stumbled across it the other day, and I finished it in 2 days, right? Yeah, 2 days. So it was really, really good. Like I said before, it reminded me of a really good Criminal Minds episode, and just even the side characters in the book were really interesting. Gary was really, really funny in the book because just the way he was really, really, like, you would think in a very dark thriller like that, you wouldn't have characters that are like that, but just what he did in the story was really cool. I love learning about Packard's past and him being gay in a small town and also being a sheriff and how he navigated that, because he does have some history that is linked to said town. Just the way that he navigated was really interesting, and I just really enjoyed the book. There is a next one in the, yeah, so I'm pretty sure this is just his series with Detective Packard, or no, Sheriff Packard. He's like acting sheriff. The other sheriff is like about to, you know, hit the bucket. So he's like acting sheriff, and there's another book in his series that the author literally just released, I think, like this month. So I'm definitely gonna listen to that soon. But right now it is 5:30 and I'm about to head to my book club. I also have to pick up a hold. I put hold Mr. Magic by, I can't remember who the author is, but I'm gonna pick up that hold while I'm there. And I'm just really excited to talk about books with some really cool people. It's our second meeting ever, so that'll be fun. And tomorrow I work from home, so I'm gonna work on my TBR for September and try to get some videos filmed. And that is that. I will talk to you guys later. So today is Friday. It is around 12 o'clock. It's lunchtime. I'm working from home today, and I just wanted to come on here and end this reading vlog. I had so much fun making this video. Like, I forgot how much I enjoyed reading, because I have not been reading for like the past 2 or 3 weeks, because I don't know why. I just like do something so hard and then I don't feel like doing it anymore for like 3 weeks, and then I find it again. I'm like, oh my gosh, this is the best thing ever. So that's really what happened with my reading. And I'm trying to just not be on social media, because this week also made me realize that like social media is not good for me. Like, I just do too much comparison. I am not really like productive. Like, I just sit and doom scroll for 4 hours. Like, I deleted TikTok last week and it's been the best decision I've ever made in my life, so that's fun. But like I was saying, yesterday I did have to pick up a hold and I forgot to show you. So This is the library hold I got, which is Mr. Magic by Kirsten White. From here, it says, who is Mr. Magic? Former child stars reunite to uncover the tragedy that ended their show and discover the secrets of its host in this dark supernatural thriller. Oh, so this is the author of The Hide. I heard a lot of mixed reviews about that book, but I'm really excited for this. I really like how it's pink. And yeah, I think this is gonna go on my September TBR. I'm actually gonna film that today because I'm going out of town this weekend, so I wanna make sure I film that before I leave. So I'm probably gonna do that during my lunch break, actually. And I forgot to show you guys, but I did make a TBR jar, so I'm gonna be doing this in my September TBR for like 3 or 4 of my physical books, because I really want to get down on my physical TBR so I can buy more books. And I'm also trying to like go through them and like be realistic, and I'm gonna be putting some, like giving some away or taking them to like little free libraries or something like that. We'll see what happens. But yeah, that is all for today's weekly vlog. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Let me know if you want more weekly vlogs like this, and I will see you guys in my next one. Peace out.